Hi, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
With my diet, you can eat all you want, anytime you want.
And you'll lose weight?
You might. It's a free country.
I've got the number one miracle in a bottle to burn your fat.
Lose fat without diet or exercise?
Stubborn stomach fat instantly disappears.
Now, there are a lot of reasons that Dr. Oz is an absolutely terrible candidate and a lot of reasons that he should never serve as a senator for Pennsylvania. But I really think that we cannot give him a pass on how big of a massive con artist he's been. And so credit to John Fetterman and his team for matching him up with Dr. Nick there. There's more. Let's take a look.
I recommend a slow, steady gorging process combined with acyl horizontology.
Garcinia cambogia extract.
Crystal sonic therapy.
Sea buckthorn.
Dr. Nick, this malpractice committee has received a few complaints against you.
Dr. Oz being sued for advice he gave to viewers who struggle falling asleep.
Dr. Oz is being accused of promoting quack treatments by some top physicians.
Are you looking for a way to slash the cost of your medical expenses?
How much would you pay for a pill that takes your body back 10 years?
Call 1-600-DOCTORB. The B is for bargain.
His empire and wealth have flourished.
The most rewarding part was when he gave me my money. Bye-bye, everybody.
I don't know what sort of Senator John Fetterman is gonna be, but I love him as a candidate. He's just provided, he has provided 60% of the fun of 2022. Sabrina, what do you think about that ad?
I mean, I've been having a blast watching this rivalry between these two. Cause yeah, Fetterman, like his tweets and memes, like they slap. And I think this is a great depiction using the Simpsons as Dr. Oz. Cause Dr. Oz is kind of a quack. He got my dad, a big health nut, to do the most random crap over the years. So I'm happy that, you know, somebody's calling him out.
Long before Dr. Oz knew that he would become a grifting right winger and try to enter the US Senate, he was making media appearances. And back in 2014, he appeared on the morning show, The Breakfast Club, and it got unfortunate. Take a look.
Okay, so he said, I can't stop smashing my cousin. We hooked up at a young age, and now in our 20s, she still wants it. No matter how much I want to stop, I always give it to her. Help me. Now, what advice would you give that person?
If you're more than a first cousin away, it's not a big problem.
Okay, so second cousin. Yeah.
You know what's so funny? Because I knew that.
Yeah. How did you know that?
Because you smashed
it. I'm from the country.
Yes,
third cousins.
Yeah, it's fine.
It's all good. Because they say first cousins, you might end up with a kid with like Down syndrome or something.
Well, it's not that. So every family has genetic strengths and weaknesses. Mm-hmm. And so the reason we naturally crave people who are not so like us is because you just have to mix the gene pool up a little bit. So that if I have one gene for, let's say, hemophilia, which is a classic example where you bleed a lot if you cut yourself. I don't want to marry a cousin has the same hemophilia gene because the chance of our child having both those genes is much higher.
Okay.
But for the vast majority of problems, that, you know, it's not an issue. But you know, that's why children, girls, don't like their father's smell. Their hormones will actually repel their daughters because they're not supposed to be together.
Right. Oh.
And so our daughter will always, my daughters hate my smell.
You just smelled.
Yeah, I think they were bringing it back to the smashing, which I don't think we need to hear him talking about smashing that much. But if it's beyond first cousins, it's not a problem. Second cousins, smash away, says the good doctor. Maybe someday it'll be codified into legislation. Anyway, JR, it's just one hit after another with this guy. He's a goofball, and he should have known going into an election that some of the goofiness was gonna come out.
Yeah, we will say at least this was a resurfaced video. He didn't say this just now. But it seems like he's doing his best Dr. Drew impression. I remember Dr. Drew and Adam Carolla used to do a Love Line, I think is what it was. And people would call him with these crazy types of questions like this. And, you know, Carolla would make fun or a little bit and joke. And Dr. Drew would give the medical approach and be very serious. And I'm wondering if that was the thought process. He's like, I'm on this radio show. They're talking about smash. I've never heard of that term before. And then goes to talking about the medical behind the real facts behind it. Well, you know, you can smash your cousin as long as it's the second cousin. Because, you know, he went to actual details there. Just kind of don't. again, this is maybe before he had any thought of running for office. And maybe this is why you maybe want to review what you said and done and thought about and had a TV show for I don't know how long. Mm-hmm. You may have said other things that people can dig up later and go, what was this about? Which, by the way, has nothing to do with whatever he says he's going to do in office. So credit there, at least, for people who may want to defend him on this. But what does he want to do in office? I don't think we have that answer either.